An economic system can be observed from different perspectives, considering individual markets, individual consumers, individual firms, and this is microeconomics. A different perspective to look at an economic system is the macro view or macroeconomics, which considers the system as a whole. What is macroeconomics about? Macroeconomics tries to understand how the economic system as a whole works and tries to focus on the relationship between the different parts of the system. Macroeconomics considers aggregate variables, that is to say, the entire level of production, rather than looking at what is produced in a specific sector. It considers the behavior of all consumers together, rather than looking at the choices of individual consumers. How much firms produce altogether, rather than considering individual choices by an individual firm. So we look at aggregate variable and we consider how these variables interact altogether to reach something which is considered to be an equilibrium. What is an equilibrium in macroeconomics is where the system assesses, where the system goes, how the system moves to reach a steady state. An equilibrium needs not to be a positive one or a negative one, but is where the system is going to go. We will see that relationships among the different aggregate variables produce, in fact, this stationary situation that we call equilibrium. And the relationship between the different variables studied produce this type of equilibrium. Different variables in macroeconomics are linked together, forming a system. How much is produced, defined by the gross domestic product, is directly related to the level of employment and is directly related, as we will see, to the level of income. To define these aggregate variables, we need to introduce models and simplifications. In fact, an economic system is something which is resulting from the decision taken by millions of individuals, by thousands of firms every day. And we cannot follow each individual decision, every little part of the system, to see how the system evolves. We consider average aggregate variables and we look at how they interact all together. To highlight the relationship between these aggregate variables, we use models. A simplification of the system, focusing on specific aspects each time, different specific aspects that consider the part we are most interested in. If we want to understand the level of production, we look at a certain set of variables. If we want to understand the level of employment, we focus on another set of variables and on what happens in the labor market, for example. Models allow to get rid of some details and focus on the specific structure that we want to assess and on the most important relations of this structure. Models also allow to highlight some of the most important relations existing between variables and try to assess the causality running from one variable to another. In fact, something which is very important to understand in macroeconomics is that even if all variables are related to each other and they are connected to each other, we will assume that causality runs in some specific directions. Sometimes this is a difficult exercise to do, precisely because we have many simultaneous relations occurring. So we could have causality going from one end of the system to the other end, and vice versa. But according to the type of model that we choose, and according to what we want to focus on, that is, the specific model that we decide to use, we identify the direction of causality, looking at which are the variables that are determined within the model and which are the variables that are predetermined.